Hello and welcome to worship with Forest Hills Presbyterian Church in Helotes, Texas. We're delighted you have joined us this day. I'm Reverend Katie Walters, and today we are worshiping on this first Sunday in the new year. We're grateful we are able to worship together even while apart, and we pray that this day finds you warm and safe as we welcome in 2023. Today we will be celebrating the Sunday of Epiphany, when the wise men's wandering has come to an end and they find Emmanuel, God with us in the manger. We'll be hearing a story by Barbara Brown Taylor entitled Home by Another Way, which beautifully portrays the story of the wise ones wandering, their instructions from King Herod, and how God intervenes in their story. This is a service of light, a service of joy, a service of celebration as we continue in our Christmas season. Friends, we pray that this service would uplift you and you would see God at work, feel the Spirit's peace, and have the love of Christ in your heart this day. Let us worship God. Please join me in our call to worship this day. O come, let us worship the Lord and consider what wondrous things God has done. The Magi who study the heavens follow a guiding star. Oh, come, let us worship the Lord and consider what wondrous things God has done. The people who live in the shadows see a glorious light. Oh, come, let us worship the Lord and consider what wondrous things God has done. The Christ who embodies the Word unveils the hidden plan, making us joint heirs of the promise of salvation through the gospel. Oh, come, let us worship the Lord, for God has done wondrous things.
Come to earth to bring us joy, and I just want to sing this song to you. Those like this, the fourth, the fifth, the minor fall, the major lift, with every breath I'm singing hallelujah, hallelujah.
Let us pray. Eternal God, 1,000 years in your sight are like a watch in the night. As you have led us in days past, so guide us now and always, that our hearts may learn to choose your will and new resolves be strengthened, through Jesus Christ our Lord, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. On this second day of Christmas, as another year draws to a close, we come together before God and with one another, confessing the ways in which we have been caught up in the frenzied spirit of the holidays and turned away from the peace given to us by God. Let us confess together. Gracious God, we would like to be among those who saw the coming of the Christ child, those who dropped all that they were doing and traveled to worship the coming of God's love into this world. We would like to be those who cared for God in infant vulnerability, who tickled and cuddled and comforted the growing child that he might know love and safety. And yet, merciful God, we must recognize all the times we are more like Herod, whenever we, in our actions or in our inactions, find our own need for control more compelling than the needs of others for health and safety. We cling to the security of our privilege rather than standing up for the rights of the oppressed. Whenever we are complicit in the harming of innocents for the sake of profit or power, or because we fear to know and to change the injustices of this world. Loving God, we confess our sins against you and one another, and pray that you will fill us with your light, that we may live our lives as true disciples in your name, without counting the cost. In the name of Christ, the one who showed us the way, we pray. Amen. Friends, hear the good news. God's light is present in this world, present in the Christ child born to lead us out of darkness, present in the star, in all that guides us to love. God's light is in the world, and the darkness did not overcome it. God's grace is in the world, and our missteps will not overcome it. We are loved. We are forgiven. Alleluia. Amen. Since God has forgiven us, let us forgive one another. May the peace of Christ be with you and also with you. Let us go together in prayer. God of our Christmas joy, break forth, O beauteous heavenly light, and illumine our way to the paths you would have us tread. In the name of the Christ child, Emmanuel, we pray. Amen. Our Old Testament reading this day comes from the prophet Isaiah, chapter 60, beginning in verse 1 and ending in verse 6. Hear now God's word for God's people this day. Arise, shine, for your light has come, and the glory of the Lord has risen upon you. For darkness shall cover the earth, and thick darkness the peoples, but the Lord will arise upon you. And his glory will appear over you. Nations shall come to your light, and kings to the brightness of your dawn. Lift up your eyes and look around. They all gather together. They come to you. Your sons shall come from far away, and your daughters shall be carried on their nurses' arms. Then you shall see and be radiant. Your heart shall thrill and rejoice. because the abundance of the sea shall be brought to you, the wealth of the nations shall come to you. A multitude of camels shall cover you, the young camels of Midian and Ephah, all those from Sheba shall come. They shall bring gold and frankincense, and shall proclaim the praise of the Lord. This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. Our New Testament reading comes from the Gospel of Matthew, chapter 2, beginning in verse 1. Hear now God's word for God's people this day. In the time of King Herod, after Jesus was born in Bethlehem of Judea, wise men from the east came to Jerusalem asking, "Where is the child who has been born King of the Jews? For we observed his star at its rising and have come to pay him homage." When King Herod heard this, he was frightened, and all of Jerusalem with him. And calling together all the chief priests and scribes of the people, he inquired of them where the Messiah was to be born. They told him, "In Bethlehem of Judea, for so it has been written by the prophet, 'And you, Bethlehem, in the land of Judah, are by no means least among the rulers of Judah, for from you shall come a ruler who is to shepherd my people Israel.' Then Herod secretly called for the wise men and learned from them the exact time when the star had appeared. Then he sent them to Bethlehem, saying, 'Go and search diligently for the child, and when you have found him, bring me word so that I may also go and pay him homage.' When they had heard the king, they set out, and there ahead of them went the star they had seen at its rising, until it stopped over the place where the child was. When they saw that the star had stopped, they were overwhelmed with joy. On entering the house, they saw the child with Mary, his mother, and they knelt down and paid him homage. Then, opening their treasure chests, they offered him gifts of gold, frankincense, and myrrh. And having been warned in a dream not to return to Herod, they left for their own country by another road. Now, after they had left, an angel of the Lord appeared to Joseph in a dream and said, 'Get up, take the child and his mother, and flee to Egypt, and remain there until I tell you. For Herod is about to search for the child to destroy him.' Then Joseph got up, took the child and his mother by night, and went to Egypt, and remained there until the death of Herod. This was to fulfill what had been spoken by the Lord through the prophet, 'Out of Egypt I have called my son.' When Herod saw that he had been tricked by the wise men, he was infuriated, and he sent and killed all the children in and around Bethlehem who were 2 years old or under, according to the time that he had learned from the wise men. Then was fulfilled what had been spoken through the prophet Jeremiah. A voice was heard in Ramah, wailing and loud lamentation, Rachel weeping for her children. She refused to be consoled because they are no more. When Herod died, an angel of the Lord suddenly appeared in a dream to Joseph in Egypt and said, 'Get up, take the child and his mother, and go to the land of Israel, for those who were seeking the child's life are dead.' Then Joseph got up, took the child and his mother, and went to the land of Israel. But when he heard that Archelaus was ruling over Judea in place of his father Herod, he was afraid to go there. And after being warned in a dream, he went away to the district of Galilee. There he made his home in a town called Nazareth, so that what had been spoken through the prophets might be fulfilled. He will be called a Nazarene." Friends, this is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God.
Home by Another Way by Barbara Brown Taylor. Illustrations by Melanie Cataldo. Matthew 2:1-2. In the time of King Herod, after Jesus was born in Bethlehem of Judea, wise men from the east came to Jerusalem asking, "Where's the child who's been born King of the Jews? For we observed his star at its rising and have come to pay him homage." Once upon a time, there were three very wise men who were all sitting in their own countries minding their own business, when a bright star lodged in the right eye of each one of them. The star was so bright that none of them could tell whether it was burning in the sky or in their own imaginations, but they were wise enough to know it did not matter all that much. The point was, something beyond them was calling them, and it was a tug they had been waiting for all their lives. Each in his own country had tried books, tried magic, tried astrology. One had lived on nothing but dried herbs boiled in water. Another had spent his entire fortune learning how to read and write in an ancient language. The third had learned to walk on hot coals, though it did nothing for him beyond the great sense of relief he felt at the end. Despite their best efforts, all three of them still felt that something was missing. They were all glad for a reason to get out of town, which was clearly where the star was calling them. Out, away from everything they knew how to manage and survive. Out from under the reputations they had built for themselves, the high expectations, the disappointing returns. And so they set out, one by one, each believing that he was the only one with a star in his eye, until they all ran into one another on the road to Jerusalem. From a distance, each thought the other to be a mirage at first, a twinkling reflection made of vapor and heat. But as they drew near to one another, they saw the star they had in common, like a tattoo or a secret handshake, something that made them brothers before they spoke. They all believed that the star was leading them to Jerusalem. This made perfect sense, because they had every reason to believe they were on their way to meet a king. They had no trouble gaining entrance to the palace. They looked rich, and that was enough to get them a royal audience. But the king they met was something of a disappointment. He was lumpy and rumpled, and he had terrible breath. His skin looked a funny orange color and sickly, as if his bile had gotten the best of him. The guards on either side of him shook in fear of their king, so much that their spears rattled against their shields. Without even comparing notes, the wise men knew he was not the person they were looking for. "Do you know of any other kings in the general area?" they asked him. He had been picking at his fingernails until then, letting them know how bored he was, but their question got his attention. He looked right at them for the first time. That was when he saw the star in each of their eyes. His own eyes grew perfectly round, like the eyes of a snake. The king asked the wise men if they would please excuse him for a moment. Then he stepped into his private chapel to confer with his clergy. They whipped out their old reference books, which smelled of mold, and told the king what he wanted to know. "Yes," they said, "there was something in the book of Micah about a new ruler for Israel, but nothing to get excited about. It was short. It had been there for a long time." It was unlikely that the men in the other room were fulfilling that prophecy. "But sure, why not? Send the wise men to Bethlehem to check it out, to save the king a little money instead of doing his own research." So that was what the king did. He gargled, combed his hair, and went back to tell the wise men they should go to Bethlehem at once, with his blessing, on one condition: that they come back and tell him who his successor was so that he could, send flowers to the new king. His breath smelled like pine saw when he said it, which made the wise men feel queasy. They knew something was not right, but once they were back out in the night air, they could see the star in the sky again, and it set their minds at rest. They followed it right to the doorway of a one-room house in Bethlehem. It was a perfectly nice place, modest but well-built, though not the kind of place where they had expected to find a king. A dog was sniffing the woodpile under the eaves in hope of a mouse. Someone was practicing the lute next door, going over the same notes again and again. The smell of dinner was still in the air, wheat cakes cooked on a griddle, greased with sheep's fat, lentils with lots of garlic and rice. The place looked so simple, they might never have chosen it themselves. But since the star had chosen it for them, they knocked. When the door opened, the couple standing behind it almost died of fright. Not that the wise men noticed. With their arms full of gifts, they crowded into the small space, bumping their turbans on the rafters and snagging their robes on the rough furniture. All they could see was the baby, who was not afraid and whose right eye shone with the same star they had seen before they ever left home. It was him, then, whoever he was. They did not have a clue, but they knew what to do. They got on their knees and bowed their heads. Then they gave him the things they'd brought for him. Gold, frankincense, and myrrh. All the wrong things they could see now. Things he had no use for. They should have brought him goat's milk, a warm blanket, something shiny to hang above his crib. But how could they have guessed? The child's parents were gracious. They thanked the strangers for their expensive gifts and held them up for the baby to see. Then, to the wise men's complete surprise, the child's mother picked him up and handed him around so that each of them held the damp, soft, living weight in his arms. When they were finished admiring him, she took her baby back, nursed him, and put him to bed. Then, before the light coming through the window of the house had entirely gone out, the three wise men fell asleep right where they sat. In the morning, when they woke, the wise men could not find their stars anywhere. They searched each other's eyes, but the stars were gone. Frantically, they looked in all the corners and under the chairs. The baby's mother even shook out his blankets, but still, no stars. Soon the wise men calmed down and said, "Never mind, we do not need them anymore." They had found what they were looking for, something they could not lose. As much as they hated to, they added, they'd better be on their way. They would not be going back through Jerusalem, they said. All three of them had woken from the same identical dream, warning them to steer clear of the city. If anyone in Jerusalem knew anything at all, they would be here instead of there. Besides, none of the wise men's old maps worked anymore. They would have to find a new way home. So the wise men picked up their packs, which were lighter than before. Then they lined up in front of the baby to thank him for the gifts he'd given them. "What in the world are you talking about?" the baby's mother said, laughing. "For the scent and weight and skin of a baby," said the first wise man, who had no interest in living on herbs anymore. "For this home and the love here," said the second wise man, who could not remember how to say it in the ancient language. "For a really great story," said the third wise man, who thought that telling it might do a lot more for him than walking on hot coals. Then the wise men walked outside, stretched, kissed the baby goodbye, and went home by another way.
Virgin would conceive and give birth to the promise.
Having heard the word proclaimed, let us affirm what we believe with these words of a Christmas affirmation of faith written by Reverend Stephen Fearing. We believe that God has come to us as a little child, making our weakness his strength, securing our salvation by becoming one of us, blessing us with a steadfast Savior, filling our hearts with joy to be shared with one another. We believe that God has birthed righteousness and justice into the world, giving us a law that will be written upon our hearts, making the cause of the oppressed the highest priority, declaring an everlasting reign of peace, defeating the power of pain and suffering. We believe that God calls us to participate in this reality of love, inviting us to proclaim Christ's resurrection at the table, transforming us as disciples to go out into the world, and sending us forth to announce his kingdom of peace and comfort, challenging us to see everyone as nothing less than beloved children. This we believe, this we preach, this we seek to embody in word and deed. Let us turn our hearts to God in prayer. God of years 2022 and 2023, and of all times and places, you have journeyed with your people from the very first moment of relationship in that garden, through the events of history, and alongside the events of this last year and the year to come. Show us each day the beauty of your creation, the strength of your human community, and the potential of our aspirations. We are grateful this day for gifts you have brought to us in this life and on this day. Even during times of alienation and exile, you still longed to bring your people back to the promise. We still find ourselves in uncertain times, disoriented circumstances, and long for restoration of your creation and your community. In that longing and uncertainty, we lift our prayers of intercession and supplication up to you. We pray for our newly elected leaders in the United States, the state of Texas, and in our own community. May leaders govern with a heart for the welfare of the people of this land and every land. May they find common ground to bring the greater good into the world. We pray for the war in Ukraine and Russia, for families ripped apart and grieving the losses of loved ones, as well as the trauma of war on their children and future generations. We pray for the women of Iran and the Iranian people seeking greater agency, equality, and opportunity for them and their children. We pray for those held hostage and without due process as pawns of states and terrorist groups. May people never be used as currency, and their humanity, dignity, and agency be preserved and always honored. We pray for all those whose lives are threatened by violence, merely for who they love, for what they believe, or for living into their authentic self. We also take this moment to pray for those closest to us who we know by name, who need your love and your care this day. Draw close to each one in body, mind, or circumstance, gentle Savior. Work within each situation a knowledge of your divine love and compassion that compels your human family toward justice and love. Teach us where we may become hands and feet that all may know your grace and your powerful love. For we pray this in the name of Jesus Christ, whom you sent that we may know the depth of your love, and that we may remember the prayer that he taught us all. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our debts as we forgive our debtors. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever. Amen.
Go tell
In his song, Home by Another Way, artist James Taylor sings, yes, they went home by another way, home by another way. Maybe me and you can be wise guys too and go home by another way. We can make it another way, safe home as they used to say. Keep a weather eye to the chart on high and go home another way. We heard in the story how the Magi pulled out their maps and charted a new way home. There's more than one way to get home that they decided. As we enter into this new year, we remember the gifts we have been given from baby Jesus, as the wise men reminded us, for home and the love here, for holding a baby, an experience that might be new and exhilarating, and a really great story, as the third one reminds us. Again, James Taylor sings, well, it pleasures me to be here and to sing this song tonight. They tell me that life is a miracle, and I figure that they're right. But Herod's always out there. He's got our cards on file. It's a lead pipe cinch if we give an inch. Old Herod likes to take a mile. It's best to go home by another way. Home by another way. We got this far to a lucky star, but tomorrow is another day. We can make it another way. Safe home, as they used to say. Keep a weather eye to the chart on high and go home another way. Friends, I pray that wherever you find yourself this day, that it would be home. And if not, may you know that our God journeys with you wherever you go. And as you go, may the Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord make his face to shine upon you and give you his peace today and all days. And all God's children say, amen.
Those magic men, the Magi, some people call them wise, or Oriental, even kings. Well, anyway, those guys, they visited with Jesus, they sure enjoyed their stay. Then, warned in a dream of King Herod's scheme, they went home by another way. Yes, they went home by another way. Home by another way. Maybe me and you can be wise guys too. Go home by another way. We can make it another way. Safe home, as I used to say. Keep a weather eye to the chart on high and go home another way. Steer clear of royal welcomes, avoid a big to-do. A king who would slaughter the innocents will not cut a deal for you. He really, really wants those presents. He'll comb your camel's fur till his boys announce they found trace amounts of your frankincense, gold, and myrrh. Time to go home by another way. Home by another way. Got to figure the gods, say, and play the odds, and go home by another way. We can make it another way. Say ho, as they used to say. Keep a weather eye, do the chart on high, and go home.